Good morning, Spareberry. I'm Amro Waraya. Today is Wednesday, March 15th, 2017.
And I'm Heaven Williams. And at this time, we'll have our pledge followed by a moment of quiet reflection.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today's quote of the day is, "One never notices what has been done. One can only see what remains to be done," by Marie Curie. In 1987, Congress declared March as National Women's History Month in perpetuity. A special presidential proclamation is issued every year which honors the extraordinary achievements of American women. Now check this out.
Born November 30th, 1924, in New York City, she was the first African-American congresswoman in 1968. 4 years later, she became the first major party black candidate to make a bid for the U.S. presidency. She also represented New York State in the U.S. House of Representatives. Throughout her political career, Chisholm fought for education opportunities and social justice. In her early life, she began her career as a teacher, went on to earn a master's degree in elementary education from Columbia University. She also wrote 2 books. Chisholm died January 1, 2005 at age 80. Nearly 11 years later, she was awarded the Distinguished Presidential Medal of Freedom.
Attention seniors, based off your designs and votes, your 2017 senior picnic shirt will feature this winning design. Now over to Nas with the morning announcements.
I'm Nas, and on this day in history in 1930, Brigadier General Wilma Vaught was born. She joined the military in the 1950s when opportunities for women were limited. The SAT word of the day is nebulous, meaning vague, cloudy, lacking clearly defined form. The drama department is presenting the hilarious comedy Noises Off. The show will run from Wednesday, March 15th to Saturday, March 18th. All shows start at 7 p.m. Tickets are $5 for students, $8 for adults, and all teachers get in free. Hope to see you there. Donate books to Mrs. Lancey's room, 126 for the less fortunate.
Katya Foman is working on her impact project for the Academy of Leadership, Law, and Public Service and is coordinated with the school in Africa to collect books for their library. There will be a donation box outside Ms. Lancey's room, 126, until March 15th. Paperback is preferred for shipping, but hardcover is also accepted. Children's and young adult books are best, but we will take all books. Thanks in advance for your generosity, Spareberry.
Since 1994, millions of dollars have been raised in pennies and other spare change by more than 10 million elementary, middle, and high school students throughout the country. The funds collected during a 3-week period benefit the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Everyone who participates is a winner.
Thank you for participating in the Collect for Cures program. You will be helping a lot of people with cancer. In fact, many of the people you will be helping are students just like yourselves. The money you raise will help the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society help find cures for cancers that are in the blood.
Pretty sure that's it.
Spareberry has accepted the challenge of helping to find a cure for blood cancer. We are joining over 29,000 schools across the nation to make a difference and raise as much money as we can. Over the next 3 weeks, our school will be working to reach a goal of $1,000. Friday, March 10th, during all lunch periods, we will be kicking off our Leukemia and Lymphoma Society fundraiser. Teachers and staff, we need your help as well. There will be a competition between departments. Let's go, Spareberry. Let's raise money for LLS.
Why so sad? Walking around with them.
Students and faculty, have you ever wondered about your great-grandparents or your regular grandparents? Well, you can find out with your free account at Ancestry.com. Get your account through the Cobb Digital Library. Open the Cobb Digital Library with your student ID number and the password is READ, and find out all of your answers. Have any questions? See Ms. Axford in the Media Center to get started. We'll be right back after this commercial break.
Ashley, and you're watching MTV Sprayberry Edition. Let's go.
Trench work. Ay, mama told me, ay, not to sell work. Mama, 17, 5, same color t-shirt, white. Mama told me, ay, not to sell work. Mama, 17, 5, same color t-shirt, yeah.
Young, freaking poppin' with a pocket full of cottage, yeah. Whoa, chemo, stop it, chopper, aimin' at your noggin, yeah. Had to call the addict, then the top, I had to chop it. Pocket watching, so I gotta keep the rocket out. Neck water, faucet water, mocking birds, mocking. At pint stocking, next keep neck. Wrist on hockey, hockey. Wrist on rocket, rocket. Lot of copy, huh? Name someone can stop me, no one. Call me Poppy, Sachi, that's my hobby. Sachi got it on a mallet, pocket rocket from a wallet. One off in the chamber.
Seniors, your Herf Jones announcements are in the media center. Please see Miss Axford to pick them up. Now back over to Heaven and Armoro.
The Zaxby's location on Sandy Plains will be holding open interviews from 2 to 5 p.m. for all students looking to find a job. Anyone interested in this should please attend the open interview. Let's send it over to Student Teacher Profile with this week's spectacular student and staff member.
Don't you forget about me.
Yo, 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 Sprayberry, it's your boy, Aaron Davidson, back at you again with Student Teacher Profile. This week's Student of the Week is Ross Lima. Ross is a senior here at Sprayberry and was born in New Bedford, Massachusetts. He plays basketball and soccer, and he has two dogs. His favorite food is chicken wings, and his favorite TV show is Martin, while his favorite movie is Undercover Brother. 5 years from now, Ross sees himself in medical school to become a surgeon. His major will be biology. And if he could live anywhere in the world, he would live in Cabo Verde. Now, this week's staff member of the week is Miss Anita Eubanks. Miss Eubanks is the attendance clerk here at Sprayberry, which means she deals with getting you guys checked in properly. She has been here for 10 years. Woo! But 5 years from now, she says that she'll be happy and retired, as this is her last year. She's born in Decatur, Georgia. Her favorite food is barbecue, and her favorite TV show is X-Files, where her favorite movie is You've Got Mail. She says that knowing that she can make a difference is the reason she puts forth her greatest effort. And that's all we have for this installment of Student Teacher Profile. I'm Aaron Davidson, signing off. Peace.
Thank you to everyone who completed an application to volunteer for the special needs dance. We had an overwhelming response. Unfortunately, we have a limited number of dance host positions. If your application was approved by Sprayberry's administration, you will be receiving a certificate which will contain specific instructions. Certificates will be delivered to your classroom by the end of the week.
If you do not receive notification, please remember there will be two more upcoming volunteer opportunities, Spruce Up Sprayberry and the Egg Drop. Stay tuned to the Swarm to hear about these details when they become available.
Spruce Up Sprayberry is on Saturday, March 25th, starting at 8 a.m. You can receive volunteer hours for your time. We will be cleaning up the school. Come out and help beautify our campus.
Now over to Chrissy with the weather.
Hey guys, I'm Chrissy with the weather forecast, and it is OD brick outside. Today, it will be sunny with a high of 43 and a low of 23 with a 0% chance of rain. Tomorrow, it will be mostly sunny with a high of 52 and a low of 33 with a 0% chance of rain. And on Friday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 64 and a low of 51 with a 0% chance of rain. Now back to Heaven and Amaro.
Now over to International Minute for a brief news flash.
Hello, Sprayberry. I'm Asha Harris with this week's
installment of International Minute. There are currently 64,000 black women missing in the United States. Natalie Wilson, co-founder of Black and Missing Foundation, and Avis Jones D. Weaver join Roland Martin Thursday on News One Now to discuss their efforts to bring more awareness to missing women of color. Missing black women rarely get as much coverage, which is detrimental to the cause of finding them. Somalia has declared a national disaster, part of what the UN calls the largest humanitarian crisis since the World Body was founded in 1945. An estimated of 6 million people need aid amid warning of full-blown famine. A northeast snowstorm put 31 million under blizzard warning. So far, nearly 7,700 U.S. flights have been canceled through Wednesday, and thousands of schools have been closed due to what could be a historic storm. That's all we have for this week's International Minute. Tune in next week for more.
That's all we have for you today, Sprayberry.
And remember, teachers, all announcements must be submitted before 8 o'clock.
That's for each day. And again, the address is sprayberrynews@gmail.com.
Remember, Jackets, together we swore.
Together we swore.